We're here today to celebrate the life and the homegoing of Miss Genevieve Gibby. And I look around here and you hear it said and say so much that you preach your own funeral. And there's no doubt you can tell by looking at this full building how loved Miss Genevieve truly is. And for us, it's a sad day. But for her, she's home. And she's where she wanted to be. And I was thinking about so much the memories and the times past, and I began to think about this scripture in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13. It says, "But I would not have you to be ignorant, brother, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For we know him, the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and the voice of the archangel with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words." And what a great comfort that is to know. And we know that death is not the end. There's a destination set for everyone. Every one of us have a place, and we choose that place. And a long time ago, Miss Genevieve made her choice. And I can also say, I was thinking about it earlier, if I had to describe Miss Genevieve as a Christian, I would have to say faithful. Because she was always, from the very moment that I came to the church, that she was a faithful member. And she was until the end. In fact, they were there the Sunday before she fell. And she always said the same thing. Whenever we're shaking hands and leaving, she says, "You're getting gooder and gooder every time." She's always an encourager. And there's a lot of things we're going to miss. And when we first started the church there, her and Aaron and Sandra, boy, they took over in the kitchen, which is a huge job. And they've done it so faithfully through the years till, you know, they couldn't as they got older and health and everything else. But there's one thing that she always made that was very much loved and disappeared very quickly, and that was her banana pudding. And everybody knows here that's had that. That was absolutely amazing. And so many fond memories, you know. And I'll also say this. There was never a service that went by that if one of you in here, a family member or friends, was sick or in the hospital or anything else, she mentioned your name. And she loved you. She believed in prayer, and she was a great lady. And I got thinking, you know, with this passage, this tells us that one day soon, and we all know this, the Lord's coming back. And the Bible says this, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Now, what's before us here is just an earthly tabernacle. But like this passage says, one day soon the Lord's coming back. And this earthly tabernacle is going to rise up. And then we're going to go with it. And guess what? The best news is the Bible says that all together we're going to meet the Lord there. And you know what, Miss Genevieve? Just a week ago, she got to do the one thing she's been wanting to do for a long time. Two things. The first one is she got to see her Savior. And then you think about the welcoming committee. I can't imagine what it'd been like to see her children for the first time in heaven Guess what? They're not sick anymore. She's not sick anymore. They're happy, rejoicing. And boy, what a great time they're having in heaven. And you know what? It's not going to be long. We're going to be with them. And you know, whether it comes through the rapture or through the grave, there's one thing for certain. We're going to see them again. If you've been saved by the grace of God, you have that same blessed hope and assurance that Miss Gina B had. The last time I remember, well, when she first fell, we went in there, and you know how she was, and she said, "What are you doing here? I didn't want anybody to see me in here like this." She said, "How'd you find out about this?" And Brother Hope stayed quiet. And you know, it wasn't long the last time I saw her, she was on that ventilator. But now, guess what? She's breathing that air in heaven, having a great time. And you know what? We're going to see her again. She's not lost. We know where she's at. And for us, it's hard. We're grieving. We're the ones that's missing her right now. But you know what? One day soon, we're going to see her again. And best of all, we're going to get to see our Lord again. And what a great time that's going to be. Let's go, Lord, in word of prayer. Dear Lord, we come to you just so thankful, Lord, for this family. And Lord, we're thankful for the time that you've allowed us to spend with Miss Genevieve. And Lord, what a blessing she was to us. And Lord, we're thankful that we know she's home with you now, Lord. And Lord, I just pray more than ever that you be with this family. Lord, just cover them with your grace. Give them the strength they need through this time, Lord. And we love you, thank you, praise you for all you're going to do in Jesus' name. Amen.
If I surveyed all the good things that come to me from above, if I count all the blessings from the storehouse of love, I'd simply ask for the favor of Him beyond mortal ken, and I'm sure that He'd grant it again. I want to stroll over heaven with you some glad day, when all our troubles and heartaches are vanished away. Then we'll enjoy the beauty where all things are new. I want to stroll over heaven with you. Thank you.
have a part in Miss Genevieve Giddy's funeral. You know, I was thinking about it when I was a pastor there, when I was her pastor there. Talking about eating, you know, it's kind of an old school thing, but she didn't invite the pastor home with her to eat lunch with her or eat a meal with her. It wasn't just a few things. She'd set the table full of food. We'd have lots of food. You know, she never would have. You know, how great it was. You know, and we think about that, and Brother Stephen said, we never had to worry about her telling us what to stop. You know, if we didn't, do something she liked, she'd tell us. She didn't think that was quite right or whatever it was. But, you know, that's a good thing. You know, that really is with that. But, you know, as we come today, you know, we think about that, you know, and this is a time that, you know, last Sunday when Genevieve took that flight to heaven, and she did, because we know she is saved, you know, with that. But at that time, you know, we kind of see death in the family. I know you did that. It was a time that it of separation. And we think that death is a time that it just takes all the joy out of life. And it hurts. It truly hurts us all as we lose somebody we love. But, you know, if we're saved, we think about it, we're saved. In Psalms 116, verse number 15, it says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saint. Now, you know, this text is not talking about that. You know, it's precious in our sight. It didn't say that by any means. But it was precious in God's sight. For one of his, as he called one of his home and allows him to come on, you know. And so we need to look at, in our case, and with Jenny, as most of the family call her, as we, you know, or in our case, when we think about that, we need to think about that this is a time that last Sunday she was saved from the challenges of this world, the challenge that we see today, the tears and the trials and the things going on, you know, the sickness and pain that she felt. You know, she's 89 years old, and she, in general, talking to you, she had a good life. And, the last few weeks, as we know, have been kind of tough and hard and hard, but, you know, the Lord decided it was time for her to go to a better place, better things. And we were talking the other night, and she had already said, I'm ready to go home to be with my children. That's what she wants, is her children. You know, most of us can never know the pain that her and Hope felt over losing three children. The struggle that was. But, you know, she said that, you know, like I said, she said, I'm ready to go home. And that ought to be a time that we rejoice in that. When she said she's ready to go home, she knew she was ready. She knew she was saved, and she knew she was going to get to, you know, to be with them. And the things of this world, are gone. In Revelations 21:4, it says, and God shall wipe away all the tears from their eyes. Now, when we look at that, the first part of that verse, we say, and it doesn't say that she wiped away the tears. It says that God wiped them away. And she got there. It says, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. That should be a comfort for our hearts to think, you know, with that. We look at death as being the enemy because it hurts. You know, it hurts. But it's really God's tool to take somebody to home. It's God's way. He does that. He brings it, you know, with better. You know, we realize that. And like I say, it's hard to say by here. But when she crossed that Jordan that Sunday, when she seen her children, She seen those, her family, you know, her mother and her dad, those people that had gone on before, when she realized that, can you imagine the reunion that they had that day? How, you know, the reunion that, you know, with that. So, you know, but, you know, when we think about that reunion, not only with her family, but also that reunion with Jesus, she's saved. You know, she probably looked at him, you know, and says, thank you for giving me the opportunity to be with my family. Salvation, you know, with that, you know, death for a Christian, that's what it really means, is about we'll be in heaven to rejoice with our Lord and our Savior, and, you know, and with that. If, you know, if it wasn't for Jesus, we wouldn't have any hope. We wouldn't have any hope that in some time in the future, if the Lord tarries his coming back, and, you know, and we're going to go by the grave. And if we didn't have Jesus, we wouldn't have any hope to know that we're going to be in heaven with Genevieve ourselves. That'll make us shout. You know, when we think about what that means, and, you know, with that, without Jesus, and I said there wouldn't be any heaven, there wouldn't be any streets of gold. There wouldn't be any pearl gates, and none of that would be true. But with Jesus, as we know we have, and Genevieve knew she had, and she, you know, and most of us and Stephen would know this, she was all the time asking prayer for her family. Things, you know, would be better for them. Things would be that, but, you know, so she was all the time. And I'm sure, you know, if she could stand up here in front of this coffin today and look at you, and she wouldn't, by no means would she come back, you know, to this, to any covenant, but if she could stand here, she'd look at, she'd say, family, friends, get your lives in order. You want to see me again, because there's nothing like this place. You know, we're all the things that we realize and all the things that we think about here and all the things that are no more. It says, for the former things are passed away. The things of this world, you know, are passed away. You know, and are not part of it. Knowing with that, you know, if we realize that and we think about it, what that means and what that is. So, you know, that great reunion that she had last Sunday. And I know it's hard, you know, and you know, but we have to realize how wonderful heaven is to her today. And how wonderful it is to think about, for you to think about all those precious memories that you have with her. You know, we love the family. We love you, Hope, very much. We love you, Kenzie. We love the whole family. We appreciate you very much. You know, but in all reality, should draw us closer. In 2 Corinthians 5:8, it says, we are confident, and I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with you. It tells us in the scripture, which God never lies, that when we leave this world, we're with Jesus. That's what it tells us. So that's something for us to, you know, yeah, is that to say that it's not going to be hard? There's not going to be moments that you're going to, you know, you're going to realize that, hey, you know, I miss her. You're going to miss her. Sure they are. But you just think about where she's at and how she's celebrating. How wonderful it is, and how true it is, you know, and how, you know, great it is. One last scripture, in chapter 14 of John, it says, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place. He got her a place prepared. I want you to have that great reunion. You know, come on home. And if I can do anything for you, we love you. We care tremendous about you. You know, if we can help in any way, you know, we will. But it is, you know, if you need anything, just let us know. Whatever. Let's go to another word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we again we bow. Lord, thank you for sending your Son that we might have eternal hope. That we might know someday that we'll be in heaven with Genevieve. Because we know she's there. Because she let us know that she was saved and that she loved you. Lord, we just ask you to be with this family. Comfort each one of Booth Hope, Kathy and all the children, Lord. And just pray that you'll be with you know, each and every one of them. Nieces and nephews, Lord, just bless them. Strengthen them. As we go forward from this time, there'll be days that'll be hard. Put your loving arms around them and comfort. Again, Lord, just ask for your wisdom and your guidance and your direction in all of our lives, Lord. Bless the church family, the Lord. Just pray that you'll be with them, Lord, as the loss of one of their members, Lord. We just pray your blessing upon them and Stephen, the Lord. Thank you for the scripture that you give us to comfort us. Precious memories, Lord. We thank you for giving us a mind to remember the great things. All these things we do ask in your precious and holy name. Amen.